Hello kids, how are you all? I hope you all will be fine and doing well, both health-wise as well as study-wise. So welcome once again to your science classes of grade 3. So kids, as you all know, in all my lecture videos which I have uploaded on YouTube, we have completed 3 topics of our science course book. That is eating habits of animals, first topic. Second was living and non-living things. And third was safety and first aid. Both the explanation part of the chapter plus book exercises, given book exercises and the question answers. So I hope you all have now completed your written work of all these 3 chapters that were to write the keywords, to write the book exercises and to write the question answers along with the diagrammatic work sequentially, properly, neatly and cleanly as well as topic wise. Those who have not done, please do it. Okay? Because now you know where you have to complete your written work. You have to use your previous class 2 EVS notebook in which you are going to do your science work. Because now in grade 3 you are having 2 subjects more along with Hindi, English, Maths. It is Science and Social Science. Okay, now EVS is bifurcated into 2 new subjects, that is Science and Social Science. And in our Science subject, we have completed 3 chapters. So from today onwards, from this video onwards, we are going to revise the chapters. Okay, and the main focus will be on the reading part. Because reading is also very important. How to read any particular word or given sentence along with understanding its meaning as well is very important. Because first thing is reading only. First you have to listen and then you also have to try to read along with me. So I'm going to read the lesson. I'm going to read whatever is given in the chapter in the science course book. A little bit slowly so that you could also follow me. You should also try to read along with me and pronounce while watching the video. Okay, so let's start our first topic. That was, what is the name of this lesson? It is eating habits of animals. Okay, so this chapter is all about eating habits of animals. Now in your class 2 also, you have studied about the chapter. You must have studied about the topic animals. Like you must be knowing animals are of different types. So many animals, they are in and around us. Some of the animals you might have kept as pet in your house also. Like cat, dog. Some of the birds also we keep as pets like parrot, ducks and all that. Okay. So many animals are in and around us. Some might be living in our locality, in and around us, and some are living in the forest region. So in your previous class, you have studied about the categories of animals on the basis of domestic and wild animals. Am I right? But in this chapter, we have studied about the types of animals on the basis of what and how they eat. What kind of, what type of food materials these animals eat. So on that basis, we have categorized the animals. So the first category was of herbivores, second was of carnivores, third was of omnivores. What is the spelling of herbivores? It is H-E-R-B-I-V-O-R-E-S, herbivores, herbs. It is made from the word herbs. Herbs means related to plant. Plant products. So now you all must be knowing because we have completed this lesson. So now you all know that yes, herbivores are plant eaters. Those animals which eat only plant or plant products like leaves, grass, soft branches of the tree, etc. And examples include cow, buffalo, horse, deer, etc. And coming to the carnivores or flesh eaters are those animals which eat flesh of other animals. Yes, carnivores are those animals who eat only the flesh of meat of other animals, mostly other herbivores animals. Okay, so examples include crocodile, lion, tiger, leopard, etc. And the third category was of omnivores. What it was? Omnivores. The word omni, it is made from the word omni. Omni means both. Omni means both. That means that it is written over here, omnivores or both eaters are those animals or are those which eat both plants and flesh of other animals. In short, omnivores are those animals which can eat both the things, plant products as well as the flesh of other animals. Okay, and the examples include cat, dog, bear, human beings, etc. So this was the basic concept regarding this particular chapter. This was the basic thing, starting point of this chapter. That knowledge should be in your mind that yes, now on the basis of eating habits or feeding habits of animals, the animals could be categorized into three types: herbivores or plant eaters, carnivores or flesh eaters, and third is the omnivores or both eaters. Okay, now let's start the reading of this chapter. So first thing it is given about, let's learn about eating habits of animals, how animals eat, food chain. Fourth point is care of domestic animals. So all these are subtopics of this particular topic. This is the main topic and these are the subtopics, or these are the key points or learning objectives which we will learn and study in this particular lesson. Okay, now let's start reading. Like us. Now there is a comma, so you have to give a little pause. Like us, all the animals also need food to live and grow. Now there is a full stop, so you have to give a little longer pause. Pause, you understand, to stop for little time. That is called pause. Okay. Let's again read this line. Like us, all the animals also need food to live and grow. Food gives them energy and keeps them healthy and strong. So this is the initiating or starting line of this chapter. That yes, like us means like us. Who are the us here? Us means we human beings. Okay, we all human beings. So like us, all the animals, they also need food to live and grow. Obviously, animals are living things, and we have learned in our living things and non-living things topic that whosoever is the living thing, he or she or it needs food and water to survive, to grow. So that's why it is written that like us, all the animals, they also need food to live and grow. Now, why do they need food? What is the importance of food in their life? So food gives them energy and keeps them healthy and strong. So this is the reason. Healthy, strong, energy. This is the basic reason for which the animals, they need food. Okay, so this is the reason. Now there was then an activity time. As you can see over here, there is a pictorial activity given which you are supposed to do. So hopefully soon you will get your course books and then you can start your doing your book exercises in the activity form or whatever book exercises is given in that particular topic in your science course book. So let's see what this activity is saying. Match the animals with their foods. One has been done for you. Now this activity time, it is asking to do that. You can see the picture of certain animals and you can also see certain food items. Now what is to be done? You have to match the food items with that particular animal who eats this particular food item generally or more often. More often or usually. Understood? You have to match these four animals with these four food items respectively which belong to them or respectively which is eaten by them. For example, it is saying one has been done for you. For example, the book has shown how to do. So one it has done. Now you can see this elephant, it likes to eat this sugar cane. So elephant has been matched with sugar cane and this matching should be done using a scale and pencil, not in this way. Okay, it should be done using scale and pencil. I'm sorry for this. This my son has done. So I will also ask him to do it again with a scale and pencil. But you people, you will use your scale and pencil to draw the line. As you can see, this line is such a straight line. So with the scale and pencil, you can draw a straight line. So this elephant, it likes to eat sugar cane. So elephant has been matched with sugar cane. Okay. Now second animal is, you can see over here, it is a horse. So what does horse eat? Milk? No. Carrot? Obviously a horse can eat carrot also. But as we know, rabbit. Carrot is more favorite of rabbit. So we will match rabbit with the carrot or vice versa. So for the horse, it has been matched with grass. Okay. Horse likes to eat green fresh grasses. Okay. Now third, cat. Cat usually likes to lap milk. Okay. As we have studied in the last section of this chapter that the animals like cat and dog, they lap their milk or liquid items. Okay. With their tongue. That is called lap. L-A-P. So now this cat has been matched with this milk bowl and fourth one is the rabbit which has been matched with this carrot. Okay. Okay. Now moving on to the next thing. Now what is written over here? Eating habits of animals. Yes. Now the topic is main for which the chapter is about. Eating habits of animals. Let's start reading. Different types of animals eat different kinds of food. Different types of animals eat different kinds of food. Obviously, all the animals, they will not eat the same food. Different types of animals are there and different types of food requirement they have. As we can see over here in this picture also, elephant likes to eat sugar cane, horse likes to eat grass, Cat likes to lap milk. Rabbit likes to eat carrot. So that's what it is written, that different types of animals eat different kinds of food. Some animals eat plants. Some animals eat other animals. Some animals eat both the plants and other animals. Yes. So in this complete paragraph, a hint is given about the herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. As in this example also, these three, this elephant, horse, and rabbit, these three are purely herbivores. They only eat plant products. But this cat, she can eat mouse also. You know, cats like to eat mouse, rat, okay? And the cat can also lap milk, okay? She can also eat bread and chapati. And chapati and bread, they are plant products. So that's what written here, that some animals, they eat plants. Means they only eat plants, like this elephant, this horse, this rabbit. They will only eat the plant products, either leaves or grasses or certain branches, soft branches of trees. So these some animals which eat plants, they are called herbivores. Some animals eat other animals. So who will be those some animals? Those will be carnivores, which will eat only the flesh of others. And some animals eat both the plants and other animals. Like we have seen over here, cat, it can eat plant product also, and it can eat other small animals also, like birds, like rat, etc. So let's move on to the next page. Animals like cow, buffalo, horse, monkey, and rabbit eat plants or parts of plants. Animals like cow, there is a comma, then pause, buffalo. You can see this comma, it is placed after the name of each animal. Okay, so when we have to write so many animals' names together, then we can put comma and we can write like this. So animals like cow, buffalo, horse, monkey, and rabbit, they eat plants or parts of plants. So these animals are herbivores, okay? Because they are eating only the plants or parts of plants. Animals that eat plants, next slide, animals that eat plants and parts of plants are called plant eating animals or herbivores. Either you can call them plant eating animals or simply herbivores. Okay. Now, wild animals like elephant, giraffe, kangaroo, zebra, and deer are also herbivores. It's not like that only domestic animals like cow, ox, horses, they are only herbivores. No, there are certain wild animals also. Wild animals, those who live in forest. There are certain wild animals also who are in the category of herbivores. Okay, who are in the category of herbivores. So as you can see the example over here, these are wild animals because they mostly live in forest. Wild animals like elephant, giraffe, kangaroo, zebra, and deer, they are also herbivores. So here you can see the picture of some animals also. Horse, monkey, this is the picture of giraffe. Next paragraph. Animals like animals like lion, tiger, cheetah, leopard and crocodile eat the flesh of other animals. Yes. Now again you can see the commas. It's not important that every time you read the comma. You can read also, you can leave it also. But if you are leaving the commas, then you have to give a certain pause while you read the next word. Either you read like this, animals like lion, comma, tiger, comma, cheetah, comma, leopard and crocodile. Or you read like this, animals like lion, tiger, cheetah, leopard and crocodile eat the flesh of other animals. Now these animals, the names which you have seen or heard right now, they are those animals that eat the flesh of other animals. As you can see in this picture, this lion, it is eating the flesh of some other animal. This tiger, it is also eating the flesh of other animal. So animals who eat the flesh of other animals are called flesh eating animals or carnivores. Now either you can learn them as flesh eating animals or simply carnivores. Okay, there is one yellow box in which there is little more knowledge. Let's know more. An animal that hunts and kills other animals for food is called predator. And the animal that is killed is called prey. Tiger is predator and deer is prey. So from this picture, you have to understand what is written over here. It is written that the animal, this animal, this carnivore who hunts, who kills other animals, this animal is known as predator. What it is called? It is called predator. And the animal that is killed, for example, deer, the animal that is killed, that is called prey, P-R-E-Y. This deer is called its prey, and this tiger will be called predator because the tiger is hunting, tiger is killing the deer. So it is called the predator, and the deer is being killed. So it is known as prey, P-R-E-Y. Okay. Here you can see the picture of lion also eating the flesh. So lion here is the predator, and this whosoever animal is, it is called the prey of this lion, this predator. Moving on to the next paragraph. Animals like crow, comma, peacock, comma, bear and bat eat both plants and flesh of other animals. Yes, now we are talking about certain animals. Those who can eat both the things. Both means plants or plant products and flesh of other animals. And the meat and flesh of other animals also. The examples are crow. A picture is also given of crow. Peacock. Peacock is also our national bird. Bear, as you can see over here. And bat. Okay, bat is that. In Hindi, we call it chamgadar. Okay, so that is called bat. So, animals that eat both plants and flesh of other animals are called omnivores. Now, this type of animals which can eat both the things, that is plants and flesh of other animals, they are known as omnivores in science. In their life, they are called by which term? They are known as omnivores. Human beings are also omnivores. Yes, we human beings also come in the category of omnivores because there are so many people so many individuals, those who eat both types of food, vegetarian as well as non-vegetarian food. And there are some human beings also of that kind, those who take only vegetarian food. Okay, so all in all, in general terms, if we will talk, then we will put human beings also in the category of omnivores. Okay, so this was all for today's session, reading session. In the next part of the video, I will continue with this chapter only with more stress and focus on the reading part of the chapter along with the explanation. By the way, explanation, book exercises and question answers, I have already uploaded in my previous videos of the parts of this chapter. But again, as we are now continuing our revision session, so again, we will revise the topic, the chapters again sequentially, okay, part wise. So that's all for reading of today. I have already uploaded the PDF of this chapter on Snapbook. So from there also you can read, do reading of the chapter and can do better in your academics. So all that for today's session. Thank you and have a nice day, and thank you for the class.